And tonight's Tell the Tape, it is sponsored by Corona, who invites you to find your beach. Dennis Galarza, nicknamed the Surgeon. And you can see he has the height advantage, but it's Cesar Allen Valenzuela who has the reach advantage in this fight. Let's see who takes advantage of that. Both fighters are in the ring. We get the official introduction from the one and only Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Buffalo Thunder Resort and Casino here in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Live on FS1, this is Premier Boxing Champions. The action begins with 8 rounds in the super featherweight division. The 3 judges ringside are Levi Martinez, Teresa Ortega, and Sandy Pino. And the referee in charge, when the bell sounds, Rocky Burke. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black and the silver. His professional record, 12 wins, 4 of those coming by way of knockout, opposite 4 losses and 1 draw. Fighting out of Guaymas, Mexico, Cesar Allen Valenzuela. And across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the blue and the neon. His professional record, 13 wins, 8 of those coming by way of KO against 1 defeat. Fighting out of Orlando, Florida, introducing Dennis the Surgeon Galarza.
To center. First in English, then in Spanish. Keep your guard up at all times. When I say break, take a step back without punching. In case of a knockdown, go to the furthest neutral corner. Don't come out of the neutral corner till I say box. Mantenga su radio todo el tiempo. Cuando digo break, quiero que se paren. En caso de una caída, va para la esquina más lejana. No salgan hasta que digo box. Hay preguntas? Buena suerte a los dos. Good luck to both of you. Shake hands.
That's Rocky Burke giving the instructions. Just a look at Dennis Galarza. He's won 8 straight fights. Says he's a crowd-pleasing fighter. His goal, he says, to get Valenzuela out early. So he told us, I'm not getting paid for overtime tonight. Cesar Allen Valenzuela says, trust me, I will show you I'm the better fighter this evening. This is round 1. Valenzuela in the black trunks. Galarza in the blue. In yellow trunks.
These are a pair of towering welterweights, both over 6 foot. You don't usually see that type of height.
Especially at 130 pounds. There's a right hand. You can see Valenzuela is definitely looking to throw that right hand.
Nice overhand, that was blocked by Valenzuela. Good stabs to the body. Galarza trying to say, when you see him working that jab, you know he's in the rhythm, we're getting in the rhythm. Ooh, good overhand.
Overhand right there by Valenzuela.
Nice
another
body
to
shot.
The body, and he goes back upstairs.
His best success has come when Galarza is in the ropes. So now let's see if he can make his adjustments. Nice check hook off the jab from Galarza.
Valenzuela's last fight, in fact, was earlier this month, September 3rd. Second round, like another right hand by Galarza.
Set up with the check left hook. This is a good little two punch combination. That's a real dangerous punch, you know. People get hurt from that.
Absolutely. Talk about the right hand of Valenzuela. Again, his last fight was earlier this month. Before that, he hadn't fought since basically November 2015. That's when he injured his right hand, injured a tendon in his right hand, had to take basically a year off.
Good stabs to the body from Galarza.
We're under a minute here in round 1.
Don't let him think. 30 seconds.
Galarza.
It's a good game plan to start with the body. You know, we know Valenzuela's got a good, decent chin.
Here comes the final 10 seconds. Check left hook. Valenzuela, right hand. Valenzuela, right hand. Galarza.
Good little exchange from both players.
Action packed first round from the surgeon in Valenzuela. You're watching the PBC here on FS1. Action packed round one as he's taking on Cesar Allen Valenzuela. You can take a look here. Galarza has won 8 straight fights. His lone loss came back in August, about 2 years ago. Lost to Vincent Jennings. Really sick. In fact, his father just thought he had a cold. He didn't tell his father how sick he was. Turned out he had stomach ulcers. He said it was a learning experience. He's been a lot more upfront and honest, he says, with his team. And he has rolled off 8 straight victories. 5 of them have come by either knockout or stoppages.
In the last round, we saw Galarza establish his jab, especially that jab to the body. Meanwhile, Valenzuela was establishing his own overhand right himself. Tough round to score. Let's see if it picks up this next round.
Valenzuela was very adamant, Austin, and he told us in the fight, I mean, he's the better fighter. He felt like he's fought better competition. But the one thing is that, you know, when you look at Valenzuela, he's got 4 losses, and he has been knocked out or stopped on 3 occasions.
And 2 of those 3 were from a right hand.
Absolutely.
Let's see if he learned how to get away from it.
In all of his losses, Valenzuela has come to undefeated fighters. Both trying to establish that jab here.
I mean, really no shame in any of Valenzuela's loss. Like you said, they were some undefeated fighters. And those fighters are still undefeated. So, you know, he tried early, didn't came up short, still got a lot of work to do. Nice body shot from Valenzuela.
Talked a lot about it. He learned a lot from those losses. He said, listen, I love throwing that right hand, and one thing I learned is, hey, I got to protect myself when I throw that right hand. Bring it back. There's their right hand there.
Good exchange for both fighters.
Minute left here in round 2. There's the overhand right there again by Valenzuela.
Over the top of your right hand. It was Galarza's coach that asked a right hand from Galarza. It sounded like Valenzuela heard him.
There's the right hand.
That was a good right hand, so he stunned him just a bit.
Don't forget that body.
Break. Now step back. It's a patrón.
Step on when she's done. Well, that's work. Let's aim.
Here comes 30 seconds now left here in round 2.
Keep touching. Come on.
Touch the body there, Valenzuela. Valenzuela comes back. Another straight right.
Right. Over the top right now. 2-3 over the top. Right now.
Some close rounds between these two.
Absolutely. Nice overhand.
Right hand, Galarza.
His coach called for that, and he executed that perfectly. A little dirty attack is going on.
That's great. That's the first. You were holding two.
Round 2 in the books. That's Cesar Allen Valenzuela.
He held the king. He was Allen. He held the king. Okay.
Rocky Burke, our referee, talking to him about holding. This is round 3. It's scheduled for 8.
I mean, so far this has been a good tactical fight. Nice little grit inside. Got all kinds of aspects of boxing in this one fight.
Keep coming.
Let's go to our throwdown scoring app. See how you, the fans, have it scored. And look, you've given a round each to each fighter. Gave Galarza the first round, gave Valenzuela the second round.
You know, they were very close, and if it was even the other way, I can't be mad at either scores. It's a very close fight.
Double jab by Valenzuela. And set it up with the right hand.
He gives that check hook right hand and he hit Galarza with.
One thing I've also noticed Valenzuela is doing, not only he's setting up that right hand, but sometimes he's caught Galarza when he dips down with that uppercut.
He's aiming for it. And you know, he used to reach with that right hand. Now he's staying on top of his feet. The right hand's gotten a lot more precise. There's that good left hook to the body.
Wait! Step back.
There's that uppercut you were talking about, Brian.
For the first for Valenzuela, this is first eighth round fight.
Galarza has abandoned that jab and he's not been as effective as he been.
Or as active. You seem like he's just waiting.
Effective or active, you know. Galarza's coach said when he's in rhythm, he's jabbing. The fact he's not jabbing doesn't seem like a good idea for Galarza.
Time! Come here, you guys. Mira, no quiere que quede agarrando tanto, okay? Quit holding so much, okay? Both of you, warning, first warning. Okay. Box!
Here's your hard warning.
No, break. Separate.
There's the right hand, Galarza.
Good
body. Tap to body, goes downstairs, come back upstairs. Combination of four punches by Galarza. You can hear the corner of Galarza. They want him to continue to let the hands go. Make him back up. Here comes the last 20 seconds of round three.
Good exchange.
Short uppercut by Valenzuela.
It got Galarza off balance.
Yes, it did. We got a tight one here in Santa Fe.
Break.
Round four. When we come back, this is the PBC on FS1.
He's around the post, he can go either way.
Welcome back. It's Toe to Toe Tuesday here on FS1. Dennis Galarza, the surgeon is what they call him. He's found himself.
I promise you.
A good one against Cesar Allen Valenzuela.
Here's a look at that combination. Galarza pulled a nice little body shot, three punch body shot combination that he came up to the top with. You know, when he's letting his hands go, he's very effective. And he can get off combinations like that. But when he's waiting, that's when, you know, he lets Valenzuela get back in the game.
Is round four. Once again, you can help us score tonight's fights. All you got to do is download that Throwdown scoring app. Get real-time CompuBox stats and the latest news and analysis as well. Take a look at our punch stats here.
Let's go, D, let's work.
Three rounds. Pretty much even. Valenzuela has thrown more. Landed just a few more. There's a right hand that glances off of Valenzuela.
He's starting to use his jab more this round than he did last round, and it's helping him out. It's keeping Galarza off and keeping him off balance.
Valenzuela giving some movement now. Under 2 minutes. There's a left hook.
He stepped around and came back with the left hook. I don't think Galarza was expecting that.
What a quick 1-2 there by Valenzuela.
Straight down the pipe. Galarza needs to get his head out the middle.
There, another right hand by Valenzuela. Good round for him so far.
He was slow pulling that jab back, and Valenzuela came over top of the right hand. I don't know, looking at Garza's body language, it doesn't look too good right now. He's either tired or slightly hurt.
Under a minute here in round four. There's another right hand by Valenzuela. Seemed to stun Galarza.
That right hand's been a major weapon for Valenzuela this fight. Galarza's got to figure out a way to get away from it.
We're still early in this fight, but it looks at this point, Galarza has a frustration look on his face.
Yeah, the momentum is really going for Valenzuela right now. And like I said, there's time. So if Galarza can figure out how to turn it around, he can put some rounds in the bag.
Another short uppercut. Valenzuela, quick 1-2. Best round of the fight for Cesar Alan Valenzuela. Round five when we come back. Welcome back. We're in Santa Fe. That's Cesar Alan Valenzuela. Boy, what a fourth round he had, Austin.
Yeah, best round of the night so far. Best round of the match. There's a good big right hand from Valenzuela. Man, those right hands have been money the whole round.
This is round five. We're scheduled for 8 here. Let's take a look here. Have you, the fans, have this one scored? And how about this? You've given Valenzuela the last three rounds.
Again.
Oh, quick 1-2. Like Valenzuela. Another one. Valenzuela.
Right now is the test for Galarza. It's a test for Galarza to see if he can weather the storm and come back.
Under 2 minutes left here.
Wait, step back.
This corner's got to get Galarza back into a rhythm. And that means he needs to get his jab off. Just to get back to his pace, his style, get comfortable. Right now, he looks very uncomfortable. And Valenzuela, he looks very, like his momentum is just is carrying him right now.
Wait, step back. Let go.
Yeah, I go back to one of the things he told us in our fighter meeting, Valenzuela did. He said, listen, Galarza is a nice little fighter. He said, but one thing I saw is that he drops his left hand. And he goes, listen, that opens up for my right hand. That's my best punch. Remember him telling us
he
that?
He sure did say that.
Here's that uppercut that has been money for him, too.
Looked like he might have hurt his hand on that uppercut.
Under a minute now, round five.
Wait! Step back.
Dennis, throw 2, 3, 4 punches, let's go. Combination.
Larza's corner imploring him to throw some combinations.
Wait! No arms. Suéltalo.
Vivo César! You're mentally tough. Let's go.
Was it the guard that 1-2 with the guard pass, but that right hand snuck through.
Yeah, I would like to see more head movement from Galarza. He's a stationary target. And now he's letting Valenzuela get off first.
Yeah, and he's just touching him and moving. You can see Valenzuela very confident here.
He's very comfortable.
Wait!
When we come back, round six. This is the PBC on FS1.
Let's go, man. Come on.
Welcome back to Santa Fe, New Mexico. This is Toe to Toe Tuesday. Brian Custer alongside Austin, no doubt, Trout. That's Dennis Galarza. Galarza 14-1. And boy, finds himself behind the eight ball here. Three fighting rounds. Cesar Allen Valenzuela. Galarza told us, listen, I didn't find out I was fighting Valenzuela until about 10 days ago. And Valenzuela said he took the fights that he had already been training, though, and he has looked good to this point. Take a look at the punch stats here. How about Valenzuela? He's thrown 240 punches. He's landed about 30% of those. It's that right hand and uppercut that's done the most damage here tonight.
And honestly, I think the right hand opened up and opened it for that uppercut. Galarza has been worried about the right hand. And he started sneaking in that left uppercut. And a sneaky uppercut again. He almost snuck in there. Now that it's round six, you know, I think Galarza needs to have a little bit of sense of urgency.
Yeah, absolutely. Step on the gas here.
Corta la lucha. Cut out the wrestling. Box.
You can hear Rocky Burke say, hey, let's fight.
Don't grab, break, separate on your own.
90 seconds left here in round six.
Now the reason why he started throwing more uppercuts, Valenzuela, is because Galarza is leaning in as he comes in. He's over his feet, and he's susceptible for that uppercut.
Break!
Right now, it's all about stopping Valenzuela's momentum and starting to gain something for Galarza himself. Right now, he's kind of cold in the water. Good little combination with Galarza.
Falling back. And then Valenzuela falling back and still connects with a left hook. Right hand. Valenzuela. Touches the body. Now, Galarza. Goes upstairs, touch the body again, Valenzuela.
Don't wait!
Stop falling in, bro.
I'm at the lead. 15 seconds. Get it.
Yeah, I've noticed Valenzuela doesn't have, you know, blinded speed, but he does place his punches very well.
Touches the body again, Valenzuela.
Step back.
Almost sound like a balloon, a water balloon popped.
Dennis Galarza had a baby boy on September 15th. He said that is his main inspiration. He's going to need something to inspire him and motivate him because he has found himself in a dogfight with Cesar Allen Valenzuela.
And he's found himself in a hole, too. You know, he's dropped quite a few rounds, and then now he's only got two left. It's time to get desperate.
That's, you know, listen, to me, that's the beauty of Toe to Toe Tuesday. The PBC here is that you got to test these prospects and see what they're about. How about that? There's that left hand again.
Overhand right, followed by a check hook from Galarza.
Oh,
nice
again.
Check hook from Valenzuela. You know, that's where Galarza needs to go to work, let his hands go. One or two punches isn't enough, and it's not creating the openings that he needs.
And when Galarza is throwing those punches, are they too wide? Halfway through round seven.
Come on, let's fight.
To jump back what you said, is yes, his punches are, they're not as crisp and not as, as accurate, you know, especially as Valenzuela, but a lot of things can be making that happen. Fatigue, frustration, you know, he's really trying to force something to happen instead of allowing it to, or creating it.
Okay? But.
See, Rocky Burke, our referee, wants these guys to fight. Stop holding.
Keep pushing.
There's the right hand again.
Punch
right
out
on the chin of Galarza.
Hey, one thing you can say about Galarza, he can take a good shot.
Punch it.
Valenzuela's from Phoenix.
Don't tie up. Don't hold.
Just touching the body there.
They both caught shots that I think stunned both of them at the same time.
You got it, Woods.
Here comes the last 20 seconds of round 7.
That right hand over the jab. Galarza brings the jab back slow. Valenzuela hit him with the counter right shot.
Final seconds of round 7. And it's Valenzuela connecting. So we're going to go into the corner here. Cesar Allen Valenzuela. Ray Flores will do the translation.
Listen, you got to keep throwing. Listen to me. This is your round. You need to win this round. Don't go backwards. You can't wait. Listen, you got to give it to this guy. This is your fight. You need to come with everything. Give me everything, all right? I want you to be alive in this round. Give it everything. You have to keep pressing him. Cut off the ring. Everything's fine. Show like you're alive. Give me some life.
You can see the corner of Cesar Allen Valenzuela basically tell him, do not step off the gas. Valenzuela's riding a 4-fight win streak. It started basically in June of 2015.
Well, he's trying to make that 4-fight streak into 5. And as far as I see, he's really winning the fight.
Yes.
Anything goes. Anything goes in this game.
Yep. How about you, the fans? Look at this. You've given him basically the last 6 rounds. Dominating fashion. Stiff jab there by Galarza. Valenzuela steps around.
Showing some footwork there.
Galarza last tasted defeat again in August 2014. So basically 2 years ago. Since then, he's been on an 8-fight winning streak. That looks in jeopardy here.
Good body shot.
No holding. Box out. Let's go.
Wait. You know what, guys? I forgot to tell you guys. We are at about 7,000 feet elevation. This thin air is not easy to fight in. I mean, you can be in as good shape as you want. It's hard to get used to this area. That might explain some fatigue from Galarza.
And again, 1-2 by Valenzuela. Again, you know.
Good uppercut from Valenzuela. Snuck it in.
Yeah, Galarza just looks tired. Again, he's from the Bronx. Look at Valenzuela. He continues to pour it on. Crowd imploring him here in the last minute.
Oh, he's just throwing bombs right now.
Big shots by Valenzuela.
Galarza's got a minute to survive.
Will he survive this last round?
It's a good smart move to hold. It's a good move right there. It's buying him some time.
Levántate.
Galarza's got nothing left in the tank, and there's 30 seconds left in this fight.
There's not lacking any heart from Galarza. He's giving it his all.
Step back.
And so.
Comes the last 20 seconds.
Punch out. Didn't. Wait.
Last 10 seconds.
Break.
And that's the fight. Dominating performance by Cesar Allen Valenzuela. When we come back, we'll find out who won this fight. The judge's official decision. You're watching Toe to Toe Tuesday here on FS1. Welcome back here to Santa Fe. You're watching Toe to Toe Tuesday here on FS1. Dennis Galarza, Cesar Allen Valenzuela. 8 rounds they just went. Let's take a look at the punch stats. You can see Valenzuela threw nearly 400 punches, making on 34% of those. And you, the fans, you basically gave Galarza the first round, but you gave Valenzuela every round after that. Austin, let's recap this fight.
Let's take a look back at the action. Trust me, there was a lot of it. The beginning, it was all Galarza. He was slick, he was fast, he had that jab moving, nice combinations. But kind of after that, Valenzuela took over. He found a place for that right hand and just never let up off of it. Due to the later rounds, it seemed like Galarza had a little bit of fatigue problems due to the altitude and maybe those right hands from Valenzuela, but still, it was a good back-and-forth fight throughout the whole fight. Nice hooks from Valenzuela, which was definitely a weapon. Some more action from round 6. Falling back, check hook, body work from Valenzuela, good uppercuts from Galarza. Exchanges from both men throughout the whole fight. Last round was all Valenzuela. You know, letting those big overhand bombs go. Let's see what goes on with this decision.
Well, the judge's official decision is in. Let's find out who won this fight. Here's Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, having gone 8 rounds, we go to the scorecards. Judge Levi Martinez scores the bout 77-75 for Valenzuela. Judge Sandy Pino scores the bout 77-75 for Galarza. Judge Teresa Ortega scores the bout 77-75 for your winner by split decision, Cesar Allen Valenzuela.
Cesar Allen Valenzuela wins it by split decision. How about that?
Well, I mean, it's all about opinion. My opinion, he had a unanimous landslide win. But I'm glad he still got the nod.
There you go.